So what are the 10 tips that will let you start doing intermittent fasting even today without putting much effort in this? My name is Adrian and I've written down for you guys 10 tips and tricks that worked for me but also for the patients that we are following and are pretty much the best tips and tricks that you can use to get the maximum results. The point number one is to start slowly. So make sure when you are starting intermittent fasting, you don't do like 20 or 24 hour fasts right away, but you want to adapt into this. So start with 12 hours fast and make sure that you gradually increase it to 16 hour fasts. Another important thing is that if your meal frequency is 5 times a day, you want to decrease your meal frequency over the time to 2 meals a day, but you want to do it gradually. So instead of jumping and changing this within one day, give your body like 3 weeks, because otherwise you're just going to shock your body. Point number two is to balance your macros. So make sure that you are consuming enough protein and fat, and this will keep you satiated between these meals. Otherwise, if you're just eating carbohydrates and you are, going too low with the fat, you're gonna be hungry all the time and you're gonna have like carbohydrate cravings and your body will go crazy. The point number three is don't mistake hunger for dehydration. So make sure that you drink enough water while you are fasting, and which brings me to point number five, actually. Make sure that you put electrolytes in the water, because many often the hunger is mistaken with dehydration, because people either go too low with water or they don't drink the salt and potassium, so electrolytes, during your fast. The point number four is keep yourself active. So make sure that you walk, make sure that you don't think about your fasting, but focus actually on working or on working out. Like keep yourself active. Don't think about it, because the more you think about it, the more you're gonna be like mentally hungry and you're just gonna overthink it. Point number five is to use electrolytes. So make sure that you put around 500 milligrams of potassium with half a teaspoon of Himalayan salt. Dissolve it in 2 liters of water and drink it during your morning while you are fasting, and this will prevent you from being hungry, from being dehydrated, and will keep you going during the morning. Point number six is make sure that try brushing your teeth while you are doing intermittent fasting. And this is a little bit, strange, I know it, but it's actually working for a lot of people. We've searched like multiple forums, and also it worked for us. We've tried it. It worked for like people that we're following. So point number seven is get enough sleep. Make sure that you sleep around 7 to 8 hours at least per day. This will prevent you from, getting too high cortisol in the morning. And it will make sure that you are not eating food and you are not having this, adrenaline rushes. Point number eight is use coffee or tea. Make sure that you don't use caffeine within 1 hour from waking up. So, of course, you can include coffee or tea, but the first hour you want to skip it. So first hour, just wake up, start working. And after 1 hour, you can have your tea or coffee. This is like a strategic approach, because your cortisol levels are higher in the morning and then they decrease gradually. So that's why you don't want to, have your tea or coffee and be caffeinated right away. But you want to wait this 1 hour, 1 hour and a half. Point number nine is you can try psyllium husk. Psyllium husk is it's like a fiber. It's not really getting digested in your intestine, and this is the approach that you can try at the end of your fasting. So for example, let's say that you are breaking your fast at 2 p.m. you can try consuming psyllium husk around 12 or 1 p.m. To prolong your fast, and this is especially useful especially useful when you are starting with intermittent fasting in these first weeks, because usually people tend to be hungry in the second part of the day, and psyllium husk won't really put you out of the fasting, and will help you with prolonging the fasting another 2 to 3 hours, and will keep you satiated. So this is like a very, you know, pretty good strategic approach that you can use when you are a beginner and you are just starting with intermittent fasting. So that's it. Those are the 10 tips. If you have any questions, comment below, and I see you in the next video.